Good evening and welcome to ISTV Evening News. This is Jalasmi Ngambam giving you the news. First headlines. Huge cage of arms and ammunition recovered by a combined team of Imphal West Commandos, 12 Maratha Light Infantry and 33 Assam Rifles at Lafupat and Nomaikong. Teachers stop evaluation of answer papers of high school leaving certificate examination, demanding increase in remuneration fee, and May Day observed across the state today. Now the news in detail. A combined team of Imphal West Commandos, 12 Maratha Light Infantry and 33 Assam Rifles recovered huge cage of arms and ammunition of Pripak in Lafupat under Imphal West and Nomaikong under Bishnupur District. Acting on a specific intelligence input, the combined team conducted search operations in the early hours of today in certain areas in Lafupat Tera, Kordak and Nomaikong. During the search operations, four persons were detained for verification. They were identified as Hisnam Biren, Ningthausam Sanatomba and his son, Ningthausam Chandrababu of Kordak Mayailekai, and Salam Magulleba of Kordak Owangleikai. They are sympathizers and overground workers of proscribed Pripak. After interrogating them, the combined team recovered 4 AK assault rifles, 195 live rounds of AK ammunition, 81 live rounds of 7.62 LMZ, 110 live rounds of US carbine, 8 lead bombs, 2 Chinese hand grenades, 9 AK magazines, 4 LMGs, 6 US carbine magazines, 1 binocular and 2 detonators. The arms and ammunition were displayed before the media persons at Imphal West Police Commando Complex this afternoon. Speaking to the media person, additional SP Dr. A.K. Jaljit gave a detailed account of the search operations. Major Aman of 12th Maratha Light Infantry was also present.
On this search operation, we have detained four persons. They admitted that they are OGWs, sympathizers in the harbourers of Pripak, and they are used as transporters of weapons, and they are helping the Pripak in these areas in any way.
About 900 school teachers who are taking answer scripts for the High School Leaving Certificate Examination 2010 at Johnson Higher Secondary School have stopped evaluation work from today. They are demanding increase in the remuneration fee from ₹4.50 to ₹10 per answer script. The teachers have been evaluating answer scripts of all subjects except mathematics at Johnson School from the 19th of last month. Mathematics is being evaluated at the Board of Secondary Education Manipur at Babupara. Talking to the media persons, one of the teachers said that they have talked to the board secretary Raj Mohan about the matter today. They will discuss it with officials of the board on Monday. Evaluation of 80% of answer scripts has been done so far. If the board does not meet the demand of the teachers, they will stop the evaluation work.
This was more in comparing with that of the existing price. So we gather here in their spontaneity. We have no leadership, we have no organizer here in this connection. So here we spontaneously present this message to the media.
As observed in other parts of the world, May Day was observed in state by different organizations with different fervor. The day is being celebrated across the planet as International Labor Day to mark the uprising of the labor class for their rights in Chicago in the year 1886. Joint Administrative Council of the All Manipur Trade Union Congress and All Manipur Government Employee Organization organized the day at its office complex at Babupara. As a part of the observance, floral tributes were paid to the departed member of the JSC. The All India Working Women Forum Manipur also observed the day at Mazorkul Community Hall. A one-day state-level convention was held as a part of the observance. General Secretary of the All India Trade Union Congress, L. Sotin Kumar, Dr. Dhanubir Laishram of the Manipur University and former Minister Dr. M. Nara, who spoke on the occasion, criticized the government for its negligence towards the unorganized working class of the state. As a part of the May Day observance, the Workers Union and the Amway Opportunity Foundation today kicked off a Clean Imphal City Drive today. Members of the Workers Union Manipur today morning cleaned portion of Khairamban Kaitel. The drive, which will continue for 5 days, will include creating of awareness among the general masses on the importance of neat and clean environment. General Secretary of the Workers Union appealed general public to support the drive. The 36th General Body Meeting of All Manipur Working Journalists Union, AMJU, was held today at Manipur Press Club. The meeting approved the resignation of AMJU President S. Hemanta. It, however, did not accept the resignation of Secretary Y. Henry. AMJU Vice President K. H. Kogan of Sangai Express has been unanimously elected president. The meeting also decided to hold a special general body meeting to discuss the financial statement of the union. Secretary in charge Anne Phillips presented the annual report of the meeting. Renewal of 147 former members and admission of 56 new members have been approved. The newly elected president assured that he would work for the welfare of the journalists and appealed to all to extend full cooperation. The meeting condoled the death of Loken of Toka and observed 1 minute silence in his respect. Two top leaders of the proscribed UNLF, including the vice chairman of the outfit, K.H. Tomba, also known as Bikram Singh or Sunil, were arrested from a rented house at Pathar Quarry in Guwahati on Friday night. The other member arrested has been identified as Lieutenant Colonel Abu, also known as Dilip or Nabin Chandra. He is about 49 years old. Both the leaders were arrested by a joint team of Assam Police, Army Intelligence and CRPF. A police source said no arms or ammunition were found from the two, but a laptop, two cell phones and ₹50,000 in cash were recovered from them. The two had arrived in a city a couple of days ago from Manipur en route to Myanmar, the source further said. Both the arrested leaders were handed over to Dispur Police Station. Discover Manipur under the Education S Department of Manipur today flagged off 3 team of educational tour for students of Phungkothang High School, Churachandpur, Moirang Multipurpose Higher Secondary School and Vishnupur Higher Secondary School. New staff and newly elected management committee of the ISTV network today held a get-together meet at its office premises today. The new president of the network, L. Dhaneshwar, speaking on the occasion, appealed all staff and management members to work in coordination with each other. He also promised to introduce new incentive for excellent news reporters. General Secretary P. Jiten, while speaking on the occasion, expressed his desire to deliver his service with dedication. He, however, said, without the cooperation of the other executive member and new staff, it would not be easy to run the organization. Legal advisor of the network, N.G. Tej Kumar, advisor C.H. Vikram and chief editor of the ISTV news program, Rupachandra Yumnam, also spoke on the occasion. The second Manipur State Games for Physically Challenged began today at Kuman Lampak Main Stadium. The inaugural function of the game, organized by Manipur Dev Sports Society, was attended by Youth Affairs and Sports Minister N. Biren as chief guest. Around 100 physically challenged youths, including 21 girls from 6 different districts of the state, are participating in the game, which will conclude tomorrow. They will compete in athletics, archery, badminton, basketball, fencing, football, swimming, table tennis, powerlifting and volleyball. We have come to the end of tonight's news, but before we conclude the headlines once more. Huge cage of arms and ammunition recovered by a combined team of Imphal West Commandos, 12 Maratha Light Infantry and 33 Assam Rifles at Lafupat and Nomaikong. Teachers top evaluation of answer papers of high school leaving certificate examination, demanding increase in remuneration fee, and May Day observed across the state today. Thanks for being with us and good night.